Yeah, welcome back students. In the previous video we discussed about how different parasites causes different diseases in the human bodies and how our immune system will react to fight against and to neutralize the effect of those pathogens and make us healthy again. So those deals under immune system, and we discussed about an immune disorder, that is immune deficiency disorder, that is HIV, caused by the family of virus, that is retrovirus, and what are the symptoms, what are the diagnostic methods, and what are the preventive measures we can take. So all those things we discussed, and what is the how the virus will activate in the body once it is entered, how it takes our cellular machinery under its control. So all the process we discussed in a detailed manner, and today we are going to discuss about another disease, that is cancer, which is a challenging disease to the scientific and medical community today. Over a million of people will die annually because of cancer. What is a cancer? How it causes? Once it came, how we can try to reduce it? What are the treatment methods? And how we can detect the cancer? That is the diagnostic methods. And what are the prophylaxis we can take to prevent the disease? So how many types of cancers? And what is the basic nature of a cell? How it is changed to become a cancerous cell? So all these things we will discuss today. So mainly the branch of medicine which deals with the study of the cancer, that is oncology. So we have to know this. The branch of medicine which deals with the study of cancer, that is oncology. And now we will discuss about what is a cancer. In a simple definition, I can tell you that cancer is nothing but loss of control, loss of control over its division, over its division, or over cell division, loss of control over cell division. As we know that according to the demand, according to the requirement, the cells in our body will divide. For example, if the life cycle of the cell is completed, it will die, and as in the place of that, the new cells will be replaced. So whenever it is required, then only cell will undergoes division, unless until it will not divide. So up to that, there is a control over its division. But in the case of cancer, what will happen? That control will be lost. As a result of that, the continuous proliferation of the cells will take place, continuous division. No one is there to check the process of cell division. So as a result of that, more and more cells will be formed, and they will be accumulated in the body. That leads to the formation of tumor. Here, this is one cell. This cell lose its ability over its control of division. So as a result of that, one cell has to divide into two, and it has to stop its division, but it will not stop. So as a result of that, so many cells will be formed, and they will be accumulated like a tumor. This is nothing but a cancer. So as a result of that, the tumor will grow in size, and what will happen? The growing cells needs more nourishment, more nutrients. So what they will do, this, for example, this is a whole tissue, and here the tumor is there, and these are the normal cells, normal healthy cells. So these are continuously proliferated cells, and they require nourishment or nutrients for its division. So what will happen? They try to grab all the nutrients from the surroundings for its growth. So as a result of that, these normal cells or healthy cells will also become weak because all the nutrients are coming here. These are grabbing the nutrients. So that's why this normal cell will also undergo death due to lack of nourishment, lack of nutrients. How it is? Because what will happen? Because due to the blood supply only, the nutrients will be supplied to each and every cell. Now, this tumor cell will release so many factors like VEGF. That means vascular, endothelial growth factor. Vascular, endothelial growth factors. So what is this growth factor? This factor is responsible for formation of blood capillaries and blood vessels. So the factor, growth factor, is released here. So here more and more blood vessels will be formed. If more blood vessels is formed, all the nutrients are coming towards this tissue. They will not go towards the healthy tissues. So all the nutrients came here and these cells will die due to starvation because they are not getting food. That's why it is a further increase in its size and number. So that scientific term for that is continuous proliferation leads to a group of mass of cells. It is known as neoplasia. That means abnormal proliferation of cells. Abnormal proliferation of cells. So this is neoplasia. So neoplasia leads to the formation of tumor, that is cancer. So now we will see the further details. What is a tumor and how many types of tumors are there? This chapter is very, very important. So what is a tumor? A tumor is nothing but a mass of cells which are having the capability to do continuous proliferation and they don't have a regulation on its cell division. So there are two types of tumors. First one is benign tumor and the second one is malignant tumor. So what is the difference between these? This benign tumor is some group of cells. Benign tumor is some group of cells which is confined to its original location. And do not spread to other locations. See here, you have to write the difference between these two type of tumors. The tumor which is confined to its original location and do not spread to other locations, and severity is comparatively less. Severity is little or less damage. This is benign tumor. That means, for example, if the tumor is found in the liver, the cells only confined to liver only, they will not go outside. But here the malignant tumor is more dangerous, and what it is, highly having the capability of highly proliferative, because they are exhibiting the phenomena of neoplasia, abnormal proliferation. Here the cell growth is rapid rapid multiplication of cells.
Rapid multiplication. Within one day, so many cells are formed.
Rapid multiplication.
So here, this malignant tumors have, now they have the capability of performing an another phenomena, that is metastasis. Very, very important. Metastasis. Already I discussed this one when we are discussing the phylum Cnidaria. They are exhibiting, Cnidarians are exhibiting metagenesis. They are exhibiting metagenesis. So what is metagenesis? Alternation of generations. Sexual stage to asexual stage. Asexual stage to sexual stage. So don't get confused between these two terms. Metagenesis is different and metastasis is different. So what is metastasis? It is nothing but a phenomena of, it is a phenomenon of migration of tumor cells. Phenomena of migration of tumor cells from one place to another place. From one location to another location. For example, what will happen? The tumor is formed in the lungs. So we are calling that as a lung cancer. And here, basically, this is a tissue and these are the cells attached to each other. Due to interstitial fluid, they will attach. So they are confined to lungs only. But the malignant tumor cells lose the capability of adhesion. That means binding capability. These cells lose that capability. As a result of that, these two cells will not be attached to each other. So they will easily migrate to another location. For example, from lungs they came to throat. And cause, for example, they came to buccal cavity region. And in the buccal cavity region, even one cell came, it starts proliferation in the buccal cavity and forms again a new tumor. Okay, we cannot call that one as a mouth cancer because it is not originated in the mouth region. It is originated in the lung region. So we can call that as a secondary cancer. Secondary cancer of lung in the region of mouth. But this is not originally a mouth cancer. And another example. If some cancer, ulcer or cancer formed in the stomach region and the cells have lose the capability of binding together. So those cells migrated to liver. So we cannot call and causes the cancer in the liver. We cannot call that cancer as a liver cancer because it is originated in the stomach region. So we can call that cancer as a secondary cancer of stomach in the liver. Okay, this is about the phenomena of metastasis. Because why they are performing metastasis? Because these cells lose the ability of binding or adhering each other. That's why they are migrating, and wherever they are going, there they will cause another type of cancer. Okay, this phenomenon is very dangerous, and this is the challenging phenomena for the scientific community, because a person is affected with the cancer at one region and he is also affected in the cancer with another region. So two treatments they have to take. So this is a very challenging topic for the scientific community. So these are the different types of tumors, and now we will see what are the different types of cancers still we have. So what are those different types of cancers? Types of cancers. So what are those different types of cancers? First one is carcinoma. That means the cancer which comes to epithelial tissues. Cancer, skin cancer, like that. Cancer of epithelial tissues. Epithelial tissues. Cancer of epithelial tissues. And second one, sarcoma. So what is sarcoma? The cancer to connective tissues. Connective tissues. Like bone is a connective tissue. Cartilages are connective tissues, and so many connective tissues are there in our body. And leukemia, cancer to bone marrow. So as a result of that, the white blood cells lose the capability of controlled division. So we can call also as a blood cancer. And lymphoma. What is lymphoma? Cancer to lymphatic tissues. Lymphatic tissues. So broadly there are four different types of cancers: carcinoma, sarcoma, leukemia, and lymphoma. These are the four different types of cancers. You have to know. There may be a chance of asking this in a match the following type of question. Okay, there is a chance. So many types: skin cancer, throat cancer, lung cancers, hepatic cancers, like that. Different type: blood cancer is there, different breast cancer is there. Breast cancer is most challenging phenomenon today, to scientific community, because so many ladies are mainly affecting with the breast cancer. Cervical cancer is there. So there are different types of cancers, and broadly based upon the tissues present in our body, it was broadly divided into four types: carcinoma, sarcoma, leukemia, and lymphoma. And what are the different types of genes which are present in our body which can cause the cancer, and which can reduce the effect of cancer? So we will see those things. In our body, each and every cell undergoes cell division. So we have to have a broad look on the cell cycle or cell division. In the process of cell division, before undergoing division, the cell has to undergo three different phases. That is G1 phase, S phase, and G2 phase. And finally, this is M phase. G0 also is here. If the cell don't want to divide further, it will go into G0 phase. Okay. Now, what will happen? First of all, before the division into two, the cell has to replicate its DNA. Already we discussed this one. Until it is not replicated its DNA, how will it will share the DNA into two cells? So first of all, it has to replicate its DNA. Now, so during these three phases, the cell will accommodate all the different types of processes, like DNA replication, replication of different types of proteins which are essential for the cell division. So these three phases are called as preparatory phases. That is, these three phases, the processes occurs in these three phases helps the cell to prepare for the division phase. So if these three phases will not occur, the cell cannot undergo the division. Understanding? So here so many different types of proteins, DNA replications will happen. So at that time, during DNA replication, if any gene is not replicated properly, it has to stop, because it will lead to mutation. It will sometimes, if the gene which is responsible for the regulation of cell division was mutated, then what will happen? The cell continuously undergone division and leads to the formation of so many cells. So that is cancer. So those genes are known as proto-oncogenes. So what are proto-oncogenes? These genes are always present in the cell and they do not cause any cancer, proto-oncogenes. But if any mutation happened in these genes, for example, this is a proto-oncogene, this is A, G, T, C, G, C, like that, this is the sequence. If the sequence is like that, the gene will not cause any type of cancer in the body. But during the replication, if any mutation happened and this sequence is changed into G, then this proto-oncogene converted into oncogene, and that oncogene is responsible for the cancer. Okay, so this is the proto-oncogene. So if anything happened here, that means proto-oncogene converted into oncogene. So the cell recognizes and it has to stop the process of replication, and the cell will be killed itself. That process is known as apoptosis, self-death, because if it is undergone division, it leads to cancer. So cell will think, I have to kill myself to protect the other cells. So as a result of that, it will undergoes apoptosis. But what will happen if the mutation is happened? The cell itself cannot be able to recognize itself that some changes have happened in myself. So as a result of that, apoptosis cannot be done, and this one cell leads to so many types of cancer cells. So apoptosis will also be not done, because the cell itself not recognizes that my genes are mutated. So this is one thing. And so many helpful genes are also there. Helpful genes. What is that helpful gene? P53 gene. This gene is also known as guardian angel of cell's genome. That means out of 30,000 genes, the P53 gene is known as angel of cell's genome. That means this gene is responsible for the detection if any mutation happened or not. If it is happened, it will be activated and cell will be undergone apoptosis. As a result of that, the cancer should not be propagated. But in the severe case of cancers, this gene will be activated and it will go and turn off this gene, P53 gene. So as a result of that, no checking process will be done and this cell undergone proliferation. See here, again I am trying to explain the concept. In the process of cell cycle, before the cell undergone cell division, so many checkpoints will be there. So many phases, G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase. So what are the importance of these different stages? Here so many processes which are required for the cell division will happens, like DNA replication and so many proteins like microtubules, so many proteins, microfilaments are needed, actin proteins will be needed for the process of cell division. So all the synthesis of those proteins and the DNA replication will be done in these three steps. Here during the DNA replication, if any mismatch happen, this normal proto-oncogenes will turn into oncogenes. So this oncogenes will normally, this oncogenes has to be recognized by this gene, and this gene activates the cell and the cell undergone death, that is apoptosis. But in sometimes what will happen, this gene will dominate P53 P53 gene. As a result of that, this P53 gene will be suppressed. So it will not be, it cannot fight against the oncogene. So now what will happen? The cell undergone proliferation and leads to the formation of different types of tumors. So this is the molecular biology which is laid behind the propagation of cancerous cells. So whatever these three checkpoints are very important. Each and every process will be checked. If everything is okay, then only the cell will allow into the further step during cell cycle. But what will happen? The checking process here also dominated by the oncogenes. So this is about the propagation of cancerous cells. Now, already we discussed how many types of cancers are there. Now, how we will, what are the reasons, what are the reagents which will cause cancers? There are different types of agents which can cause the cancer. Those agents are known as carcinogenic agents or carcinogens. Carcinogens. So what are carcinogens? The chemicals or anything, the agents which can cause cancers. Agents which can cause cancer. So this is known as carcinogens. We can broadly divide the carcinogens into three different groups. First one is physical agents. Physical agents. Second one is chemical agents. Chemical agents. And the third one is biological agents. Biological agents. So what is physical agents? Like, the physical agents are ionizing radiations. Ionizing radiations. Ionizing radiations like X-rays and gamma rays. X-rays and gamma rays. And the second one, non-ionizing radiations. Non-ionizing radiations like UV rays. So that we are not supposed to expose for X-rays, gamma rays and UV rays much. That's why the pregnant ladies are all not advised to take the X-rays, because the inside baby is very sensitive. Even if you went for one X-ray, the baby cells will undergo mutation and leads to the formation of cancer. So the pregnant ladies are advised to go away from the X-rays. And UV rays, as you know, that if you are exposed to UV rays for 1 minute, there may be a chance of getting mutations. Next, chemical agents. Chemical agents, mainly we can say that tobacco. It leads to different types of cancers, and mainly lung cancer and throat cancer. Tobacco. What are the chemicals which are present in the tobacco leads to the cancer? Those are benzopyrenes. Benzopyrenes, these are the chemicals. And nitrosamines. Nitrosamines, these are also leads to cancer. And in the labs, laboratories, we will use different types of chemicals. For example, ethidium bromide. Ethidium bromide, this will also leads to the cancer. Ethidium bromide. And so many chemicals like asbestos, silicosis, these are the occupational siderosis. These are the different types of asbestos. The people who are working in the asbestos company or the silicon stone crushing factories or iron factories, what will happen slowly during the occupational time leads to occupational hazards, and these particles will be accumulated in the lungs, finally leads to mutation of the cells. So lung cancer will come. So due to occupational hazards also, there may be a chance of getting the cancer. Okay? And what are the biological agents? These biological agents are nothing but a type of virus, which can cause the cancer. So these are the biological agents. Ross sarcoma virus. This will cause the cancer. Human papilloma virus. It will cause cervical cancer. Okay, these are the different types of biological agents, physical agents and chemical agents which will cause the cancer. Now we will see, once cancer came into the body, and that means the cells are undergoes continuous proliferation, so how you will detect the cancer? So now we will see the process of diagnosis. So what are the different, the basic diagnostic method to detect the cancer is biopsy. It will come under histopathological studies. So what is histopathology? Histo means tissue, pathology means disease, study of diseases, that is pathology. What will happen? For example, cancer was happened to the liver. They will take a piece, a small piece of tissue from the liver, and they will send to the lab. In the lab, with the help of microscope, they will study the liver tissue, and they will detect whether the tissue is infected with the cancer or not. They will study that one. So these are the histopathological studies. Studying the disease of a tissue, that is histopathology. The science which deals with the study of diseases, that is pathology. And the science which is studying, deals with the study of the tissues, that is histology. Okay, so combination of that, histopathology. And different types of tests are there for different to detect different types of cancers. So what are those? Pap test or pap smear test. Actually, this is, test is used for detecting the cancers in women, and they will, pre-cancer conditions also we can diagnose with this type of test, whether she is prone to affect with the cancer or not. So pre-cancerous conditions we can detect in, especially in the woman. So this type of test is known as pap test or pap smear test. And biopsy already we discussed, and blood tests. So first of all, in the case of leukemias, that is in the case of blood cancers, the number of white blood cells will be increased enormously. So by diagnosing simple blood test, we can detect the blood cancer. So to confirm whether white blood cells count will be increased even because of an infection also. So to confirm that one, again they will do tests for the bone marrow, so many tests they will do to diagnose and to confirm it further. But basically, if the person is almost okay but the white blood cells count is enormously increased, then there may be a chance of getting some idea about leukemia. So for further confirmation, they will do bone marrow, everything, bone marrow testing, like that. Next, PSA, prostate specific antigen test. See, they in our test book they told that some antigen antibody specific test will also be used. I am giving you the example, prostate specific antigen test. This test is used to diagnosing prostate cancer. This is the most common cancer in the men. Prostate gland will be affected. Prostate gland is associated with the reproductive structure of man. Okay, because this cancer cell is changing its surface antigens. Because already I told that if some cell is changed, that will be diagnosed, detected by our immune system, and immune system will go and kill that cell. So our natural killer cells, different types of macrophages, will detect if the cell is changed its structure. So what will happen, as how we can detect, we will use that antibodies so that it will go and bind and gives the fluorescence at that specific region. So by that antibody and antigen interaction, we can detect where the cancer is. Okay, this is about prostate specific antigen. And mammogram, the name itself tell indicates mammo, that means mammals. What is the definition of mammals? The animals which can feed, which can nourish the babies with the help of milk, those are mammals. So that means here it is used milk, it where it will come, it is come from the breast. So to detect breast cancer, this is the best method. To detect breast cancer, mammogram is nothing but a X-ray, a special type of low energy X-ray beam. Because if the high range of X-ray beam, if you will index that, it will leads to mutations. So low energy beam of X-rays, that is mammogram. Low energy X-ray beam. Low energy X-ray beam, that is mammogram. And as usual, we can know that X-rays and CT scan, computerized axial tomography or computerized tomography, CT scan means. CT scan, computerized tomography, it will give two-dimensional view of each and every cell, where it is undergone mutation, where a continuous proliferation is happening. So this is also basically X-ray, but it will give 2D or 3D images. Okay, and MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI scan, magnetic resonance imaging. Magnetic resonance imaging, MRI scan. This will also, this is a non-ionizing radiation and the most safest method of diagnostic techniques. CT scan, it is involved in X-rays and normal X-rays. These are very dangerous, but MRI scan is a very friendly to use because it doesn't give ionizing radiations. It is very safest method of diagnostic method, MRI scan. So with the help of MRI scan also, we can diagnostic the presence of tumors. So these are all the different diagnostic methods we can use to detect a person is infected with a cancer or not. And now, treatment protocols. So how many ways we can treat the cancer patient? These are the protocols are different from one cancer to one cancer. For example, if a person is infected with the breast cancer, so what is the treatment protocol? Simply, they will remove that breast. So as a result of that, they are eradicating the spreading of those cancerous cells to other healthy tissues. So that process is known as surgical removal. Surgical removal of affected portion. Mainly this type they will following the type breast cancers. And the second one is radiation treatment. They will expose the tissue with the high energy radiations like gamma rays. So as a result of that, what will happen? The cell undergone again, it will be mutated and it will stop division. So that is a radiation therapy. And chemotherapy. Radiation therapy. And the third one is chemotherapy. Chemotherapy. They use different types of chemicals which can stop the mutation, that will stop the continuous proliferation, that is neoplasia. So during that continuous chemotherapy, the patient will develop so many side effects are there. So that is insomnia, loss of sleep, insomnia, and alopecia. Insomnia, alopecia. What is alopecia? Alopecia is nothing but a loss of hair. So total hair they will lose because the side effects of these chemicals. That is alopecia. Insomnia, they will not get sleep. Loss of sleep. Completely still there is no cure for different cancers also. The patient ultimately has to die. Even for example, in so many cases, what I have seen is they went to treatment and the doctors will discharge after 6 months or 8 months, and they told that it is completely cured. So they are going home, and within 1 year or within 8 months, again they are infecting with the same type of cancer, and again they are coming to the hospitals, and at that time they will lose their lives. So what is happening? Even during that treatment protocol, even one single cell is remained, single cancerous cell is remained at that place, it will start its division and again it will increase its population and again it will lead to the cancer. So the treatment protocol, they have to follow utmost care, utmost observation. Each and every cell has to be killed. No one will be remained at that location. So it is a very critical treatment protocols they have to follow. Okay, so these are the different types of, and some drugs are there, for example Taxol. What is this drug? It will stop the continuous division of cells at least for some days. So this is one type of drug which will be used in the cancer treatment. Okay, and we can also use the new science, that is monoclonal antibodies. We will see what is this monoclonal antibodies. So what these antibodies will do, they will go and block the antigens. As a result of that, it cannot change its surface antigens. And NK cells, natural killer cells, monocytes, macrophages, they will come easily and they will bind to the cancer cell and they will kill the cancer cell. Okay, these are the different types of treatment protocols still we are using for the treatment of cancer patients. See, awareness is very important here. That means we have to be stay away from the high radiation regions. First of all, we have to avoid the smoking habits, chewing tobacco. So all these leads to the development of mutations in the cells and leads to the cancer. Okay, this is about the topic cancer. And tomorrow we will see what are the different drugs, drug abuse, how the youth is changing their lifestyle and how the youth are more prone to taking different types of drugs. and what are the effects and how the life will be spoiled if a student, if a youth is going attracted towards taking different types of drugs. So tomorrow we will see that drug abuse, how the drugs are affecting the prosperity.